Hello guys, welcome back to Civil Stuff by JP. So today in this video we will see how to do rate analysis of M20 grade of concrete. So first of all, we should know what is rate analysis. So rate analysis is nothing but finding the rate per unit of any item or work. Finding the rate per unit of any item of work. So in this case we are going to calculate the rate analysis for concrete. So the unit of concrete is meter cube. We always calculate the concrete in meter cube. So finding the rate per meter cube is nothing but the rate analysis of concrete. So for rate analysis we need to find, first is material estimation. Then second is labor estimation. Third, water charges. Fourth, the tools and equipments we require for concreting. Fifth, the contingencies, and the last point is contractor's profit. By adding all this amount we will get our rate of concrete per unit. Okay, by adding the amount of all these things, that is the amount of material required, the amount of labor required, the water charges, the amount of tools and equipments, contingencies and contractor's profit, we will get the rate of concrete per meter cube. Then let's see what is concrete. So concrete is nothing but a mixture of cement, sand, which is also called as fine aggregates in technical language, and coarse aggregate. And we also need to add water in this. So the basic materials we require is cement, sand, coarse aggregate and water. We also add admixtures if required. Admixtures are added to change the properties of the concrete. So this is not mandatory, it is only added if required. So the basic materials we have is cement, sand, coarse aggregate and water. Now concrete is of two types. First is PCC and second is RCC. So PCC stands for plain cement concrete, and RCC stands for reinforced cement concrete. So what is the difference between this? So in PCC we do not add steel in it. Okay, when there is no steel in concrete it is called as PCC, and when we add steel in the concrete, that concrete becomes RCC. So this is the basic difference between PCC and RCC. Now let's come back to M20 grade. So in this M20, the M stands for mix and this 20 stands for the compressive strength of concrete after 28 days of curing, and its unit is Newton per mm square. So we can say that if you are using M20 grade concrete, its strength should be 20 Newton per mm square. So this was all the basic things we need to do before we start our rate analysis. Now for rate analysis we have two tables. As you can see, so the first table is for material. So for rate analysis, we need to add the amount of various materials. So we are going to calculate the amount of cement, sand and aggregates. And the second table is for labors, labor estimation. So for concreting, we need different labors and we have different rate for that labors and we will calculate the amount. So these two tables we require for rate analysis. So now let us assume the weight volume of concrete as 1 meter cube. We will do the rate analysis for 1 meter cube of weight concrete. So our first step is calculation of quantities of different materials. So now always remember that for calculation of quantities of different materials, that is nothing but cement, sand and aggregate, we use the dry volume of concrete, not the wet volume. Keep this in mind. So the dry volume is equal to wet volume plus 54% of the wet volume. We need to add 54% in the wet volume. So the wet volume is 1 plus 0.54 multiplied by 1. We will get our dry volume as 1.54 meter cube. So we will find all the quantities of materials using the dry volume. So now as you can see, we add 54% in the wet volume. So why only this 54%? So as we know, in the materials like cement, sand and aggregate, there are certain voids. There are certain gaps in it. In technical language, it is called as voids. In technical language, it is called as voids. So in cement, the percentage of void is negligible, as the cement particles are very fine. Okay, as the cement particles are fine, we can say that the percentage of voids in the cement is negligible. Now in sand, the percentage of voids is around 22 to 27%, and in the coarse aggregate, the percentage of voids is around 32 to 34%. Now let us consider the extreme case. The percentage of voids in sand is 27% and the percentage of voids in coarse aggregate is 34. So if we add this, we will get the percentage of voids as 61%. So now when we add these materials, that is cement, sand and aggregate, when we mix it in dry state, that is dry mix, when we dry mix all these three materials, certain percentage of voids is been removed. So that is 7%, around 7%. So if we deduct 7% from the 61, we will get our answer as 54%. So that's why we add 54% in the weight volume to get our dry volume. I will show with one sketch. Suppose this is cement. As the particles are very fine, there will not be any voids in it. Then if we consider sand, there will be certain voids which will be around 22 to 27%. So the voids in it is 22 to 27%, and when we take coarse aggregate, the percentage of voids is more, that is around 32 to 34%. So that's why, as per the calculation, we add 54% in the weight volume to get the dry volume. Now let's move back to calculation of quantities. So our first quantity is cement. So for calculating the quantity of cement, sand or aggregate, we have one basic formula. It is dry volume divided by the summation of proportion multiplied by proportion of particular material. Now for calculating the quantity, we need proportion. So for M20 grade, the proportion is 1:1.5:3. In this, one part stands for cement, 1.5 part stands for fine aggregates, or we can say sand, and 3 parts are for coarse aggregates. So our proportion is 1:1.5:3 for M20 grade. So now we have the dry volume as 1.54 meter cube divided by the summation of proportions. So we will simply add the proportions, 1:1.5:3 multiplied by the proportion of specific material or particular material. So as we can see, the proportion for cement is 1, so multiply this by 1, so we will get our answer as 0.28 meter cube. So we will get our answer as 0.28 meter cube. Now as we know, the cement we order is always in bags, number of bags. So one bag of cement contains 0.0347 meter cube of cement. So to convert this meter cube into bags, we will simply divide this by 0.0347. So 0.28 divided by 0.0347, we'll get our answer at 8.06, which is equal to 9 bags. Now second, sand or fine aggregates. So use the same formula, 1.54 divided by 1:1.5:3 multiplied by the proportion of sand. Now the proportion of sand, that is fine aggregate, is 1.5. So multiply this by 1.5, we will get our answer as 0.42 meter cube. Now find the quantity of coarse aggregate by using the same formula, 1.54 divided by 1:1.5:3 multiplied by the proportion of coarse aggregate is 3. So we will get the quantity of coarse aggregate as 0.84 meter cube. Now we are having the quantity of cement, sand and coarse aggregate. So now add these quantities in the table as mentioned in the previous. So now let's add the quantities of cement, sand and coarse aggregate. So in this we have one table, that is unit. So cement is always calculated in number of bags. So the unit of cement is bags and the unit for sand and coarse aggregate is meter cube. It is always calculated in meter cube. Now we have to add the quantities. So add all these three quantities in the table. So 9 bags of cement, 0.42 meter cube of sand and 0.84 meter cube of coarse aggregate. Now here you can see that there is one column of rate. So we need to add rate of cement, sand and coarse aggregate to get the amount of that. So for getting the rates, always refer DSR. So DSR is nothing but district schedule rate. Each individual district is having one separate DSR in which we have the rate for different materials as well as labors. So let us consider DSR Pune. So I have taken the rates from DSR Pune. So for cement I have taken the rate as 300 per bag. For sand I have taken the rate as 1600 per meter cube and 800 per meter cube for the coarse aggregate. Now simply multiply this quantity by rate, you will get the amount. So the amount will be 2700 for cement, 672 for sand and 672 for coarse aggregate. Now this was material estimation. We first calculated the quantities of cement, sand and coarse aggregate. Then we added the rates of cement, sand and coarse aggregate from DSR and simply multiply the quantity by rate, you will get the amount. Now similarly, we have to do labor estimation. So we will require some labors for doing this concreting work. So as per IS 7272, the labor required for 1 meter cube of concrete is as follows. So we require 0.1 mason, 2.33 mazdoor or helpers who will help the mason, and 0.8 bishti. So bishti is nothing but the person who waters the concrete. Okay, so we require these labors for 1 meter cube of concreting. So now we will again take the rates of this mason, mazdoor and bishti from DSR. So the rates are as follows. Again, simply multiply the quantity by rate, you will get the amount. So the amount will be 50,582 and 162. Now we have the amount of material and labors. So simply add the amount of materials and labors, you will get the total amount. Which will be 4836 rupees. So this is our total amount. Now in this we need to add the water charges, the charges for water. So it is around 1.5% of this amount. So that will be 72.54. We also need to add 1% for tools and equipments. For tools and equipments, we will add 1% of this amount. So that will be 48.36. And we will add contingencies. So as per IS 7272, the contingencies is 3% of the total cost. Okay, so the contingencies will be 145 rupees. And finally, we will add the contractor's profit. So the profit of contractor is around 10% of this cost. So it will be 483.6. So now add all this amount, you will get the final amount of concrete per meter cube. So by adding all this amount, we will get our final answer as, we will get the final amount as 5585.5 rupees. So we can say that we will require or need 5585.5 rupees to carry 1 meter cube of concreting. So this is how you can calculate the rate analysis for different grades of concrete. The procedure will be same as explained, and for different grades the proportion is different. In the description box I have attached the link from where you can get the proportions for different grades of concrete. So now let's see why rate analysis is important. So from rate analysis we can first find out the accurate amount required per meter cube per unit in a specific locality. Okay, for example we have calculated the rates in Pune, so we can say that the rate per meter cube for concrete in Pune is around 5000 rupees. So this is the first use of rate analysis. Then we can know the quantity of materials and labors required. So from rate analysis we can get the quantity of materials and labor required. Third, we can know the rate of materials and labors, okay, from DSR. We have referred DSR, which is district scheduled rate. Each individual district is having one separate DSR. So by referring that we will get the rates of different items and different labors, okay. And the last and the important thing of rate analysis is that suppose we are having one work and we require contractors for doing that work. So when the contractors quote the rates, we will have one rough idea of that work, okay. These were the various importances of rate analysis, and the rate analysis depend on various factors like the quantity of material, quantity of labor, the rate of material, the rate of labors, okay, and the grade of concrete. Thanks for watching. If you like this video, please give a thumbs up and share this video with your friends. Thanks for watching.